Well, hello, Lakeside. This Sunday is going to be week number 12, where we haven't met together, but we've live streamed. But as you've already heard, the good news, exciting to me, hopefully exciting to you, the week following, June 7th, we're going to be back together. In my Bible reading this week, I was in Romans chapter 1, and Paul, who longed to get to Rome, and we know, if you've studied the Bible at all, you know that eventually he's going to get to Rome, but it's going to not be in freedom, but it's going to be as a prisoner. And when he goes to Rome, he's not going to leave Rome. He's going to die in Rome. But he longed to see the believers in Rome. And in verse 12, this is what he said. He's saying, I long to be with you, see you face to face, that we may be mutually encouraged by each other's faith, yours and mine. And that's how Christianity was meant to be lived, shoulder to shoulder, face to face, locking arms, serving the Lord together, encouraging one another, lifting up those who are going through a difficult time, challenging those who maybe pride's taken over in their life, but doing life together. Paul said in Romans 1, just a little bit later, a verse that's very common to many of you, and certainly is true for me, and I pray is true of you, for I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone who believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For everyone, it's the power of God unto salvation. Now, I know that through the live stream, with the numbers that we've received, we've had numbers of people that have been able to hear the gospel that have never walked through the doors of our church building. And so God has used this time. But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't all desire to get back together. Now, we've tried to be very considerate of everybody's opinions, everybody's life circumstances over these last almost 12 weeks now. And there's a lot being said in the news and in the media and in the neighborhood. And so we've tried to be considerate. But we've tried to communicate with you all the way along, doing these videos and Preston sending emails, and this is what's going to happen. But we've had this desire to connect, and we've tried to connect in the best way possible through Zoom, through other means. But nothing is going to take the place of connecting face to face. Now, I pray that you're preparing yourself and that you're comfortable with coming back together on June 7th. We're taking some very reasonable precautions. We're going to treat you like you're adults. We're going to give you all the information, all the measures we're going to take, and we're going to let you decide. We don't want to guilt you into coming. We're not going to guilt you if you don't come. This is individual soul liberty. But for me, I'm anxious and excited about getting together. Now, this Sunday, there's going to be a special message from Philippians chapter 2, verses 12 through 18. And I want you to read that passage ahead of time. We're going to honor a few graduates through live stream, through a little video that we've put together. We want to encourage you and challenge you. So join us this Sunday for our live stream. Invite others to come. And you know, when we get back together June 7th, we're still going to continue the live stream. So for those of you that are a little distance away and have connected with this live stream, you can stay connected that way. I want you to have a great day today. Have a great weekend in the Lord, and look forward to getting back together so we can mutually encourage one another and in each other's faith, yours and mine.